Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why? There is only one God. La ilaha illallah. There is only one God. La ilaha illallah. Lord above the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why? There is only one God. La ilaha illallah.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back to the best of stories from the Quran. Brothers and sisters in Islam, we talked about the first kind of test that we go through, which is the test that has to do with the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordained upon us. And briefly, we introduced the second test, which is the al-ibtila al-shar'i, the ibtila in the area of the shar'. What that means? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created us to worship Him, to obey Him. And meanwhile, He placed within us the freedom to choose. You see, the rest of the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are unwillingly submitting to Allah. Submitting to Allah. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالطَّيْرُ صَافَّاتِ كُلٌّ قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحَهُ. Can't you see that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, everything in the heavens and the earth, even the birds, praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تُسَبِّحُ لَهُ السَّمَاوَاتُ السَّبْعُ وَالْأَرْضُ وَمَنْ فِيهِنْ. Here it is. وَإِنْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبْحُ بِحَمْدِهِ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَسْبِيحَهُمْ. Everything is in a state of submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only two creations who were equipped with the freedom to obey or not to obey are the jinn and the ins. قال الله تعالى about mankind, إِنَّا هَدَيْنَاهُ السَّبِيلَ إِمَّا شَاكِرًا وَإِمَّا كَفُورًا. We shown him the two ways, whether to be grateful by being a Muslim or a disbeliever. وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجِدَيْنَ. The same thing. وَنَفْسٍ وَمَا سَوَّاهَا. And by the soul and the one who perfected it. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. That nafs, that soul is ready to go to goodness or to wickedness. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Successful is the one who takes it to goodness by purifying it.
وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ دَسَّاهَا.
A loser is the one who takes it to wickedness by not purifying it. Brothers and sisters in Islam, implementing La ilaha illallah is the second test. And a lot of us, a lot of people are failing in this test. And don't be surprised. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّوكَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَكْثَرُ النَّاسِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتَ بِمُؤْمِنِينَ. The majority of people have failed in this test. I'm talking to those who are holding fast in implementing the test, the servitude. Remember the covenant that we talked about the last episode? The covenant of servitude, that you're going to be a slave to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That you're going to do the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded you to do. And this is, by the way, what a lot of people do not realize. That to succeed in this test, if you're commanded to pray, you must pray. If you're commanded to fast, you must fast. If you're commanded to give zakah, you must give the zakah. If you're commanded not to commit adultery, you're not supposed to commit adultery. If you're commanded not to drink alcohol, not to smoke drugs, not to drink whatever it is, not to be nasty to your neighbors, and on and on and on. Any time you violate one of these commands, you are violating that La ilaha illallah, and you are failing in that test. And subhanAllah, a lot of Muslims do not realize that there are actually enemies out there trying to make you fail. And that this is what makes this test so difficult. Number one, it is not easy. Commands, implementing them is not easy, because you must train yourself to get used to it. Two, you have the freedom of choice. You have a choice. You have temptations out there. Three, there are enemies. عَلَى الرَّصَدْ. Enemies who do not want you to pass. And this is, by the way, my next episode. And one of these enemies is Satan. But those enemies are three, brothers and sisters in Islam. The three enemies who do not want you to pass the test, who do not want you to submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to become a Muslim. Number one, you. You, yes, you, your nafs. Your nafs is the first enemy that you must wage war against. You must. Two is shaytanul ins, your friends, the friends who do not want you to pray, the friends who do not want you to be a Muslim, the friends who do not remind you with Allah, the friends whom when you hang around with, they take you to drink, they take you to adultery, they take you to smoking dope, they take you to doing haram. Those are your enemies. And they can be the closest to you. And then comes in the third enemy, which is Satan, brothers and sisters in Islam, Shaitan. And subhanAllah, we've been going through the series, and already our father is not in existence, and Satan is already what? Yeah, subhanAllah, claiming that he's already our enemy. And this also showing, by the way, even once we were born, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-hadith fi Musannaf Abdul Razzaq, but the hadith has some origin fi al-Bukhari, hadith Abi Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِن مَوْلُودٍ يُولَدْ إِلَّا وَيَسْتَهِلُّ صَارِخًا. Every newborn, once they come out of the womb of the mother, what they do right away? They cry. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam actually explained why they cry. Why they cry? Because shaitan stabs them. Shaitan will stab that baby, except Maryam alayhi salam and her offspring Isa alayhi salam. Except those two, they did not, they will be protected because of the dua, because of the invocation, the supplication of the mother of Maryam when she said, وَإِنِّي أُعِيدُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانَ الرَّجِيمِ. I seek refuge with you, O Allah, on her and her offspring from shaitan. So shaitan, brothers and sisters in Islam, your nafs too, and your bad friends are sworn enemies, and they do not want you to pass the second type of test, which is implementing la ilaha illallah, which is becoming a Muslim, which is implementing the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they always try to take you away from submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Insha'Allah, bi-ibnillahi ta'ala, the next episode of the best of stories, we will talk in more details about the story of those three enemies and how can you combat them, each one of them. And that will lead us to Satan and his animosity against us. And that will lead us, insha'Allah, to the issue of when that animosity practically happened between us and Satan, which is the story of prostrating Adam alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, prostrating to Adam alayhi salam, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the angels, when Iblis was there amongst them, to bow down to Adam alayhi salam. And the angels did, because we know that the angels, they worship, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and willingly, but Satan refused. And we'll find out why he refused, because of arrogance and pride. And then he started basically rejecting. And that is why, subhanAllah, you see, Satan does not want you to pass the test, the second test, which is implementing the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because himself did not pass. What got Satan in trouble?
Satan was the most pious, the righteous, the most righteous of his race. He was so far righteous until when he was commanded to prostrate to Adam, alayhi salam. It's a command from Allah. This is not sujood ibadah. This is not a worship to Adam. No. A ta'ah, an obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once you do it, you're doing it for Allah. Obedience to Allah, not obedience to Adam. Like Umar ibn Khattab, when he was kissing the stone, كما في البخاري, the black stone. What did he say? والله إني لا أعلم أنك حجر لا تضر ولا تنفع. By Allah, I know you are a rock, a stone that benefits not, that harms not. لولا أني رأيت رسول الله يقبلك ما قبلتك. Has it, I seen that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم kissing you, I would not have kissed you. إن شاء الله, brothers and sisters in Islam, I really decided to dedicate before I carry on those two episodes. This episode, which is the two types of tests that we go through, and the episode about the enemies who want to distract us from succeeding in the second test, with the most important test, I wanted to dedicate two episodes to those two issues, because they are so important before we carry on talking about Adam alayhi salam and the scene of prostration, and why Adam refused, and why Satan refused to bow down to Adam alayhi salam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, till the next episode of the best of stories. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
There is only one God, la ilaha illallah, Lord of both the earth and sky, who knows all the answers to where, what, and why. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah. I've seen the perfection of all creation in every creature and leaf, and I don't understand any woman or man who denies the one true belief. There is only one God, la ilaha illallah.